HQ curve. Let us consider a pump of either category, positive displacement or rotodynamic, in a system as shown, where the discharge pipe is open to atmosphere and the pump is discharging. It is most likely that the discharge pressure gauge will show near zero pressure. This is because there is no back pressure. In this change scenario, you will find that the pump is now showing pressure on the gauge as it is discharging. This pressure is usually a result of the head that the pump has to pump up to, plus the effect of frictional and velocity losses. This verifies our basic principle that a pump does not build pressure, but simply creates flow. We also find that in both scenarios, the flow rate through the pump varies. This variation of flow rate with respect to head against which a pump has to work is called the HQ curve and is given by the manufacturer of the pump. It is also called the pump performance or pump characteristic curve. HQ curve of a positive displacement pump. Head, Q, capacity. In these pumps, the change in flow rate with change in discharge head conditions is very small, as we can see from the near vertical line. This is because, irrespective of the head, the number of strokes per minute of reciprocating pump or number of turns of a gear or screw per minute will not change and will discharge near constant quantity. HQ curve of a centrifugal pump. In these pumps, energy is imparted to the fluid and then it is left on its own to cope with the discharge heads. If the discharge head is too high and consumes the entire energy that the pump produces, the flow will stop. The maximum head of a given pump is called the maximum shut-off head of that pump. This column of liquid and gravitational force exerted by it fully counterbalances the kinetic energy developed by the pump, and hence the flow stops. Head versus capacity. Thus, in centrifugal pumps, the change in flow rate with the change in discharge head conditions is quite prominent, as we can see from the arc of the HQ curve. Greater the head, less is the pump capacity. Ideally, the best efficiency point, BEP, of a centrifugal pump is about 80 to 85% of its maximum shut-off head. However, due to other interfering factors, this may deviate by a maximum of 10% on either side.